welcome to Stingaree Stadium as we get set for the first game of district action, the Texas City Stingarees and the Goose Creek Memorial Patriots. We appreciate you joining us here, whether you're watching on the rebroadcast on Comcast Sting TV or on YouTube. Check it out on YouTube if you haven't seen it there as well. Ronnie Hazard, along with Jim Tortorese tonight, Dennis Disney Johns is not with us as he's on a Disney cruise watching Mickey and Minnie and all those folks. But Jim, glad to have you. Looking forward to a great football game tonight.
Yeah, great to be here for the opening match here in the district season, District 24 4A, getting to kick off tonight, and the Stinks look to make an impression and start strong early.
Well, it's kind of interesting when you just glance at stats, and I know a lot of times you throw stats out the window, and sometimes they really do mean something, but when you look at the stats from these two teams, look like mirror images.
Yeah, both teams like to run the ball and try to control the clock. They do, though, have the ability to go deep, as both teams have passed for nearly 300 yards, averaging about 16 yards per catch for the Stings, a little over 11 for Goose Creek. So both teams have explosive players.
We'll take a break, be back in a minute as we stop for the national anthem. That took us a chance to just take a spot peek at the crowd, Jim, and there's, it's probably the rain all day that has driven some folks away. Not a lot of folks here on either side of the stands. Maybe as the day goes on and they see it's not going to rain, they'll come out.
Yeah, you definitely hope that those hometown Sting fans make it out. Cheer on the black and orange here as the captains make their way out to the center of the field. Captains for the Texas City Stingarees, number 22, Avery Fuller. Number 31, A.J. Thomas. Number 55, Matt Martinez. And number 64, Jimmy Helene.
For the Patriots from Goose Creek Memorial, not sure about number 7. We think it might be number 8, Zane Renewal, but definitely number 10, DeAndre Durden. You'll hear that name a lot tonight. Number 44, Darius Montgomery, and number 51, Kenneth Camp. As I was looking through their roster today, Jim, I also noticed something that kind of jumped out at me. Looks like 45 men on the roster, 32 seniors.
Yeah, they have 8 returners on their defense and 8 on their offense and 5 on their defense from last year's team. And they went to the second round of the playoffs by district finals.
As we said, it looked like mirror images of each other. I don't know. Well, I know that these two teams have not faced each other as Goose Creek Memorial has only been playing football a couple of years. They started as a high school with just freshmen and sophomores in the 2008-2009 year, added seniors in 2010, so they've been playing with a full class for just a couple of years. It's only probably their second, maybe third year, so we'll don't know a lot about them except that they do throw.
And we'll get a chance to see their offense first as they elect to receive to start this first half. Sting's defense going to go out and try to stop that running attack. As you mentioned, Durden, one of the lead rushers for this team coming into the game tonight.
Both teams ready. I stepped out for a minute to say hi to my dad, and I want you to know it is humid out there. This is one of those nights that I'm proud to be up here in the AC, although it's so humid outside that the glass is starting to fog up on us. We have to look for little holes to view the game through, and I'm sure that makes you folks feel really bad for us. So we're about ready to get started. Texas City, like Jim said, will kick off, and we'll see their defense first, take a look at the Patriot offense. First district game, Texas City. It doesn't get any easier. It never does in this district. Here on the Gulf Coast, Texas City goes and visits Pearland Dawson, one of the top-ranked teams in the state, next week at the Rig in Pearland, followed that by a home game against Friendswood. So nothing easy for the next couple of weeks for Texas City.
Got a good chance to get a week off and, you know, lick those wounds after a nice pre-district season, challenging pre-district season. Saw them go 2-1, and now we started up for real.
Aaron Clace ready to kick it off and get this game underway for Texas City. As he puts a foot to it, this game is underway. Taken at about the 12-yard line. Big hole and all kinds of room across the 40 to the 42, 43-yard line.
That's that mystery man number 7.
I knew that was going to happen to us.
And unfortunately, it's not Verniel because I did see him out there wearing number 8. So the Patriots will start their first offensive possession at their own 43-yard line. And coming up out of center, looks like it's going to be number 10, DeAndre Durden, the quarterback. Two men in the backfield and two split wide. Durden's going to turn and hand off. Actually going to drop back to pass as he hit, as he's released. The ball floats incomplete downfield. Good pressure that time by the Texas City front four.
And both receivers covered well on that play again as they fake it up the middle and try to go for goal on the first play of the game, try to catch Texas City napping, but it did not work. It'll be second and 10 now for the Patriots.
Outside linebacker Adrian West that time in on the pressure on Durden, forced the errant throw. Durden will come back out. He'll have receivers, two to the near side, two men in the backfield. He's going to turn and pitch wide to the right. He finds running room to the 50, 45, 40. He's got some open running room down to the 20, 15, 10, 5, and a touchdown early for Goose Creek.
Deontay Foreman trying to run him down but just couldn't get there as the speed of the Patriots showed right there.
And we're going to have to try to find a name on that kick because he's obviously one of their go-to men.
Something there tells me we're going to be calling his name tonight.
Lining up for the kick for Goose Creek, number 35. Ball's down, kick is up.
Hits the crossbar, so it's no good. We'll take the break with 11:35 to play here in the first quarter. The Patriots 6, Texas City nothing. Well, last time Texas City was on the field, we got to say Aaron Clay set the kick a lot of times. We hope not to say that for the Patriots tonight, but they're getting ready to kick off after a quick score, 57-yard run by Alexander. This one's taken at about the 24-yard line by Armonte. No, I'm sorry, that's Donald Lynch with the run back to about the 30. So Texas City will start first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
Texas City obviously likes to control the ball with the run. Rawls, obviously the leading carrier on the team, averaging over 8 yards a carry this season. But they have a lot of weapons on that offense.
Andrew Allen, quarterback for Texas City, as he has been all season. Number 21, Deshaun Rawls, and 7, Deontay Foreman in the backfield. Allen under center on the first play from scrimmage. Rawls gets the call, trying to get outside. He's got some room across the 40, 45, 50. Down to the 40, and be forced out of bounds at about the 35-yard line. The flag comes in late, comes flying in as he's out of bounds at the 39. We'll see what the flag's all about.
Great job there finding the edge, and you see the speed. We talked about it. Each team has very explosive skill players, and Rawls showing why he's one of the best in the district. That time he was forced out of bounds by, I believe it's number 32, Mitchell Hudson.
Personal foul against the Patriots will give Texas City some added yards and push the line of scrimmage now inside the 25 to the 24. Texas City ready to go. As Foreman comes in motion from the far side, that's Armonte. DeAndre gets the call straight up the middle, big hole across the 15, falls forward to the 12-yard line. Boy, he had a hole that I could have walked through.
Yeah, the guys up front doing their job early on. First play, they get the seal block to get spring them on the outside. That time they just move the guys around up front and make a big hole for them to walk right through.
Colby Johnson coming into the game for Texas City as they'll bring in three backs. Johnson will actually be out in the slot. Armonte Foreman out wide. Deontay gets the call again. He's around the outside, and he's going to go very close. Yes, touchdown for Foreman from 12 yards out. So Texas City answers quickly. Boy, that's just exactly what you want to see when you get down that quick.
That that time you got Rawls out front with the lead block, and that's what sprung him to get to the right into the end zone there. Last man had a chance, and Rawls just pushed him right back into the end zone. Great answer drive.
Three plays, I believe, plus the penalty.
70-yard drive, three plays with the penalty of 15 yards. Key run that time, obviously, was the 46-yard run to start the ball game.
Aaron Clace set to kick the extra point, the go-ahead extra point. Good snap. Kick is up, and it's blocked.
They got a chance to return it, but Texas City back there to make the stop.
Finally do. So, man, deja vu all over again as Texas City gets their extra point blocked. So, with 10:51 to play in the first quarter, Texas City 6, the Patriots 6. Man, how crazy is it? Aaron Clace to kick off for Texas City after the touchdown. Ball taken at the 10. Stopped at the 20-yard line. That's number 7.
Curtis
Granberry is what we're now being told. We apologize. He wasn't on the roster, and then we just assumed it was somebody else because he'd been carrying the ball a lot. But we got it straight now. Thank you, Mr. Dickie Campbell.
And Texas City will, they have a nice stop there on the kickoff return, so Goose Creek's going to have to start out at their own 21-yard line to begin this drive. And Durden this time has Montgomery and Granberry in the backfield. Trips to the near side here. Hand off up the middle. Now we go around the corner, and Durden finds the corner and good running room out to the 39-yard line that time. Pickup of 18 yards on the first down carry.
Stop made by Texas City's Deshaun Rawls, number 21.
That time they just run the option, fake the handoff up the middle of Montgomery, and Durden was off to the races as he found the corner. Suck the defense in.
First down for the Patriots from their own 39-yard line.
Durden hands off to the first man through. That once again is going to be...
Oh, Texas City's got the ball. Looking to get the number of that truck that came in and got it.
34 for Stings.
34 is Corey Robinson.
Corey Robinson, looked like the handoff was right up the middle to Montgomery that time, and Texas City Sting defense able to pop it free.
Big, big turnover by the Patriots, and Texas City gets the ball after just a couple of plays.
A game like this, turnovers are going to be the key, obviously. Try to win that takeaway battle.
So Texas City starts at the Patriots 42. Handoff this time up the middle, bouncing off. That's Deshaun Rawls, and he'll get to the line of scrimmage. Actually going to give him a yard.
Thanks to Coach Cooper out there helping us out.
Well,
see
what,
right?
Head varsity baseball coach got a raise and got the squeegee getting the fog off the windows. It's off season. Second and 9 for Texas City. Allen with Rawls and Foreman split in the backfield. Two wideouts to the near side. Allen stops, steps back, going to run it as he comes to the near side. He's across the 35, falls forward to the 30-yard line. He's going to have the first down. Nice 9-yard, 10, 11-yard carry for Andrew Allen.
Big pickup there on the first down. Finally brought down by Don Rittenhouse and DeAndre Durden.
So Texas City, fresh set of downs, first and 10. They'll mark it at the 30, their own, or the Patriots 30-yard line, 6-6 with 9 minutes to play still in the first quarter. Allen from under center Deshaun Rawls gets the call, bumps into a man, bounces off of him. Now he's looking for some room, comes the other way. He's got the corner. He's at the 20. The 50, he'll go out of bounds at the 16-yard line. What a nice run as it was supposed to go the other way. Ran into the back of one of his own players trying to block for him. Just came back this way and had some room.
Great blocking out front that time. LaTroy Wafer, the junior left guard, was able to spring him on that backside. And while we have a chance, we'll go through the starting lineup up there on the front. Jacob Stanley, number 73. Wafer, number 56. Hideo Hanlon, number 54. Gabe Garza, right guard, number 55. And right tackle, Daniel Tarver, at number 75.
First down again for the Stings. Allen with the handoff to Rawls. Rawls bounces to the outside. He breaks the tackle. He's at the 10, inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line goes Deshaun Rawls. So the first series was Deontay Foreman left, Deontay Foreman up the middle. This time, it's Deshaun Rawls, and both of them, the Patriots can't stop so far.
A great 1-2 punch, you know, and you haven't seen a lot of Deontay Foreman. I believe he's been nursing a couple of injuries, and he came out, started the game tonight, and took off right out of the bat, then come right back with the 1-2 punch with Rawls this drive.
Second and one for the Stings from the 7-yard line of the Memorial Patriots. Rawls trying to get outside. This time he won't get out of the arms of a Patriot. He'll lose a yard.
Number 84 that time on the stop for the Patriots. Travis Costler brings up a big third down here. They can pick up that first down. They reach just inside the 6-yard line of the Patriots.
Third and two for Texas City. Colby Johnson goes in motion. Allen going to keep it, gets caught in the backfield and gets away from one, but won't get away from a second one. Well, actually he does, and they're just not blowing the whistle, and Allen just keeps going the other way. He'll finally call it dead at about the 17-18 yard line.
Yeah, finally brought down that time by the linebacker. Got a big loss there. Texas City will have a choice to make. It looks like they're going to bring on the kicking unit.
Aaron Clay says, come on, sets the tee down at the 25, so it'll be a 35-yard attempt from the near hash mark. What little bit of wind there is, it'll be to his help. Good snap, hold us down, kick us up. It's high and going to be just good. From this angle, couldn't really tell. The 35-yard field goal by Aaron Clace is good for Texas City. Gives them the lead with 7:24 to play in the first quarter. Texas City 9, the Memorial Patriots 6. We'll be right back. Aaron Clace set to kick off after the 35-yard field goal from his foot. Gives Texas City the lead 9-6. Alexander, all kinds of running room on that far side. He's across the 40, across midfield.
We've got a flag.
Flag down at the Patriots' 40-yard line. Did we decide that number 7 was Alexander?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
That's our story, and we're sticking to it.
That's right. They're going to bring that one back, just like Jim saw, as both teams coming back to the Patriots' side of the ball. So they'll start this drive after the penalty. Was an illegal block. It'll be at their own 30-yard line, same place they started the last drive. After two plays, they fumbled. Texas City took advantage of that. Couldn't put it across the goal line for 6, but got it just inside the crossbars for 3.
This time, Durden will send 2 receivers here to the near side. He's got 2 men in the backfield with him. That'll be Alexander and Montgomery. Pitch out wide this side, and not a lot of running room that time.
Not at all. I believe that's Colby Johnson, the first black jersey there, and had 3 or 4 of his good friends on defense to help him finish Alexander off.
Yeah, Chris Gray also back there for the Stings.
They're going to give him a yard.
He does a little tentative running into the line there that time. You see Johnson on the other side of the line. I think I'd be tentative running that way, too.
That is one big black jersey staring at you when you look up and see him in front of you. See that big 36. Second and 9 for the Patriots.
Handoff up the middle that time. Montgomery able to stumble forward for about a 5-yard carry.
Deontay Foreman threw his buddy in there to knock him off his feet. So it'll bring up 3rd and 5 for the Patriots.
Nearing the halfway mark here in the first quarter. Stings up by 3 by virtue of the nice 35-yard field goal. Fakes the handoff. They're now going to pitch to Alexander. He's got a first down and a little bit more as Alexander carries out over the 45-yard line to the 46.
Senior Dominique Allen, number 17, makes the stop. But like Jim said, not before the Patriots move the chains.
District 24-4A figures to be tough yet again. You lose one great team, you pick up a couple more.
That's the truth.
Every week's going to be a dogfight.
No rest for the weary. I was watching, or looking at Dave Campbell's Texas Football Today, and they do pick Goose Creek Memorial as the 4th playoff team in this district.
3rd and back to pass. Going to get it off completed. That time it's going to be to number 8. And that is Zane Verniel. Verniel looks to have picked up first down yardage as they have an 11-yard pitch and catch. That'll take it into Sting territory down to the Stingaree 43-yard line.
Donald Lynch trips him up to make the stop, but the chains move again. It's the Patriots on the downhill side of the field now at the Texas City 43.
This time for Neil and Kobe Shoemaker split to the near side for the Patriots. Durden turns and hands off up the middle to the first man through, and that's going to be Montgomery, and he's going to rumble down to near the 35-yard line, picking up nearly 8 yards on the first down carry.
Donald Lynch again on the stop. He goes low to knock his feet out from underneath him. That is one big, we don't have number or sizes of these guys, but that is one big good-looking fullback.
Yeah, he's very solid. Reminds you, number 44 for the Baltimore Ravens, Vontae Leach, former Houston Texan. We saw him quite a bit in the past few years.
Yes. 2nd and 3 for the Patriots.
Trips to the near side for Durden. He'll turn and hand off. It's going to be Alexander.
Oh, nice. Grab the jersey and save it a long run. Alexander looked to have some room, and all of a sudden Corey Robinson reaches out and grabs a handful of white jersey and brings him down.
Yeah, nice open field tackle there. As you saw it, the hole was opening up, but it closed in a hurry.
Brings up a big 3rd down, 3rd and 3 for the Patriots from their own 35-yard line. I'm sorry, from the Texas City 35.
3rd and takes his time and barks out the orders. Now he'll turn to hand it off. Actually, he's going to keep it in pitch. And Alexander's going to find the wide side, picks up first down yardage and a lot more as he carries down to the Texas City 19-yard line.
That's Donald Lynch again on the stop. Makes the touchdown saving tackle just inside the 20.
16-yard carry that time for Sean Dre Alexander. And there's going to be a timeout taken here by the Texas City Stings.
We'll take it with them with 4:09 to play in the first quarter. Texas City on top, 9-6. Both teams back on the field after Texas City's timeout. 4:09 to play in the quarter. Stings up 9-6, but the Patriots are knocking on the door. 1st and 10 from the Texas City 19-yard line.
DeAndre Durden up under center this time. He's going to turn, hand it off up the middle to the first man through. Not a lot of running room that time as the Stings converge early.
Lead number 6, Devontae Hinton, one of the first Stingarees there on the stop.
Montgomery again on the carry, but only able to pick up 1 yard. as the Sting's defense tries to bow the neck a little bit here.
That's what you like to see after a timeout is a defensive stop.
Yeah.
Feel like you got your money's worth anyway.
Take your time and talk it over and get things back under control here. Jordan will take the snap. Fake. He's going to roll out to the right here. Looking for a receiver downfield. He doesn't have one.
Nice job. Devontae Hinton comes up and pulls him down from the blind side for a loss of a couple back to the 21-yard line.
Yeah, nice job there. 3-yard loss. Brings up a nice long third down opportunity here. Sting's defense doing the job in the last two plays.
Third and 12 for the Patriots. And now they're going to call a timeout and talk about it. With 2:50 to play in the first quarter, Texas City on top 9-6. We'll be right back. Patriots and Stingarees back on the field. After this time, the Memorial Patriots took a timeout. They're looking at third and 12 from the Texas City 21-yard line.
Great opportunity here for the Sting's defense to limit the damage. As Durden comes in up under center. He's going to drop back and pass quickly. And it's in and out of the hands of the intended receiver that time, Zane Verniel. And that'll be fourth down and a kicking opportunity for the Patriots.
That pass thrown at about his shoestrings. It was going to be tough to catch. He had a little bit of room out there, but it was a tough one from the beginning.
Yeah, I think he saw a matchup he liked out there. Just couldn't get it quite to the receiver. Rushed it a little bit. Stings will take the benefit of that. As number 35, Hector Godinez is the kicker for the Goose Creek Patriots.
37-yard attempt, and we've got flags.
Not sure if he was drawn off. The man on the end over on the side jumped a little early.
Here comes the call. Oh, big break for Texas City as it will be against the Patriots and back it up 5 yards. And I tell you what, I've not seen their kicker, but that makes for a long high school kicker field goal.
Yeah, 44-yard attempt. This will be interesting.
From the near hash mark, no wind now at all. Flags laying down on the poles.
Kick is up and it is no good. Got a little bit. I think the Stings helped themselves out there with a little bit of a tip at the line of scrimmage, but that ball really didn't have a chance from the get-go.
So Texas City holds as the Patriots try to answer Texas City's field goal, but couldn't do it as it was short. So Texas City will take over first and 10 at their own 23. I'm sorry, that's the 26, isn't it? Own 26. From the shotgun on first down, that's Armani Foreman in the Wildcat. He's going to take it and tries to go to the far side. Breaks a tackle across the 30, 35. It's hit and goes down as a flag comes in as he gets down to the 40. Flag back at the 35. It's going to be against Texas City. Be an illegal block against the Stings.
Nice run that time by Foreman. He was able to elude the first tackler.
Moves the line of scrimmage back. Penalty from the infraction makes it the 25-yard line. Texas City needs to get to the 36, so it'll be second and 11. From the shotgun, Allen hands off to Deshaun Rawls, breaks a tackle, but can't get out of the hold of the next one. So he'll get maybe a yard.
Yeah, that illegal block was downfield, so it brought up a first and 11. as opposed to your standard holding, which would have been a first and 20. So the Stings catch a little bit of a break on that.
Gain of one for Rawls will make it second and 9 now for the Stings, as we're down to a minute and 45 seconds and counting to play in the first quarter. Allen will go under center. Deontay Foreman in the backfield by himself. Take the handoff and Allen rolls to the far side. He's going to have some running room. Gets down across the 35 to the 36. He's going to be very close to the first down.
Looks like they're going to mark him just a little shy. It might be close enough for a measurement, though.
They're thinking about it. And, yep, they're going to bring the chains out and take a look at this. So Allen on the keeper rolls out, gets away from one would-be tackler, and then gets, we'll see, maybe enough for the first down.
That time he had a run-pass option. He had Lynch coming open there in the flat, decided to take it on his own, and going to be real close for the first down here. Just a little short.
Yep.
By about 6 inches, it looks like.
So Texas City will be looking at a third and inches. From their own 36-yard line. Both teams scored on their first possession with some big runs, and Texas City answered back with a 35-yard field goal after the turnover by the Patriots, and that's where we're at, 9-6. Allen under center now. Lynch and Foreman in the backfield. Allen's going to keep it himself, and he'll have the first down. So he just barrels forward for a yard to gain, and that'll move the chains.
Nice push by the big boys up front. Enabled Allen to pick up the necessary yardage there.
Adrian West brings a play in from the sideline. He'll be out split wide out here to the near side. Armonte Foreman to the far side with Lynch and Deontay Foreman in the backfield. Allen under center, rolls to the near side. Got Foreman blocking in front of him, going across the 40 to the 45-yard line. So it'll be a nice gain of about 7 yards. Call it 8 yards. Well, yeah, 8 yards on first down for Allen.
Yeah, nice job there on the first down run. Pushed out of bounds that time by number 2 for the Patriots.
Texas City to the line of scrimmage, 2nd and 2. One wide out, that's on Monte Foreman. Deontay gets the call, and he's going to get right close to that first down marker, maybe just shy of it before he gets pummeled back. But they're going to give him the forward progress, but I believe he's going to be about a football length shy.
Yeah, nice push forward there, but still a little shy. Going to bring up another short third down conversion attempt here.
Stings looking to the sidelines to get the play. Down to 15 seconds and counting to play here in the first quarter. They'll have to get the playoff as they're down to 5 on the play clock. Johnson goes in motion. Ball's on the ground. Picked up. And nobody's stopping him. Touchdown, Patriots.
Number 33 that time. Don't have a name on him. The name that we have on the roster is obviously not correct, but he was there, Johnny on the spot, right place, right time, able to run it in.
That is not what you want to see as the quarter goes to zeros. They'll attempt the extra point. things come in, but the ball's not snapped. So. Going to be against the Patriots. So they'll back it up, and the extra point will be a 25-yard attempt.
Gudinha's out of the hold. It's going to be blocked. Sting's got an opportunity to take this back. Picked up, and he's got a lot of room in the blocking.
Got the block, he sure did.
He's going to go all the way back for the two-point conversion.
Wow, what a crazy, crazy game this is. As Devontae Hinton, number six, I believe that's who that is.
Yep.
Through the fog of the glass. Hinton picks it up, gets a big block at about the 40-yard line that cuts him free, and nobody stops him. And we're going to go, that's the end of the first quarter after simply the touchdown by the Patriots, blocked extra point, run back for 2 points by Texas City. After one quarter of play, Goose Creek Memorial 12, Texas City 11. We'll be right back with the second quarter in just a second. Boy, I'm getting too old to remember what all's happened this first quarter, Jim. I think we've had two quick, long touchdowns. We've had both extra points blocked from each team. Then we had a 35-yard field goal by Texas City. Baytown missed about a 40-yard field goal attempt. Texas City fumbles. Patriots pick it up and go about 35 or so yards for short kick. Is going to hit the ground. And still, anybody's ball. Finally, Texas City falls on it at about the 34-yard line. Wow, that was close as the little pooch kick did the Patriots. I believe that's Dominique Allen, number 17, that falls on the loose ball.
Yeah.
So Baytown picks up a fumble from Texas City, runs it in as the quarter ends. They kick the extra point. They attempt the extra point. It's blocked. Devontae Hinton picks it up and runs about 85 yards for the two-point conversion, 12-11, Sting's behind.
Not lacking for entertainment value tonight, are we?
Who needs Disney?
We miss you, Dennis.
Yeah. Wow, Texas City starting from their own 34-yard line. Under center, Allen takes a snap, fakes the handoff, and looking to throw downfield.
Oh.
And just
wide receiver stopped on the route. Allen had all day back there. Great play fake that time.
Oh, it was.
Hit the ball behind his back. Had everybody fooled in the stadium. Unfortunately, Foreman stopped his route, or else he might have had an opportunity that time.
Both teams have had the ball three times in that first quarter. Now Texas City ready to go. Second and 10 from their own 34. Armani Foreman out wide to the far side. Pitch goes to Deshaun Rawls trying to get that left side behind a nice block from Deontay Foreman, and he'll be right at the first down chains. He just, that's good patience. He just waited for that block to develop, the play to develop. Deontay Foreman got the block to spring him forward, and they're going to mark him out of bounds about a yard shy, third and one for Texas City.
Yeah, not forcing the action there, just picking his spots, looking for the block to develop, and again, able to spring it out. What could have been a 2 or 3 yard pickup turns into a 8.5, 9 yard pickup on second down.
Third and one for Texas City, Allen under center. And we've got movement on the line by Texas City, and that'll back it up. I think there was one referee that didn't pull his flag out.
Lot of laundry.
Third and six for Texas City, makes the new line of scrimmage the 38-yard line. They've got to get down to the 44 to keep possession of the ball. Two wide out split to either side. Andrew Allen will be in the backfield with Deshaun Rawls standing to his right. Straight drop back. Screen set up nicely. Rawls has got the ball and some running room. There's a blocker. He's at the 50. Sidesteps 140. Still a blocker in front of him. 30. Cuts it up. And it's going to be nothing but dirt and touchdown for Texas City. It's no dirt anymore, though, is it? It's that rubbery stuff.
That's right. a lot of rubber tread coming up out there.
Absolutely. Nice play for Texas City as they take it in for six on the screen.
Great blocks downfield that time for the Stings. Hideo Hanlon out there along with Armani Foreman and Adrian West leading the way. And, you know, the mark of a great receiver is not always the routes you run or the balls that you catch, but blocking on and running plays like that and blocking downfield. That time, Stings got two great blocks from both their wide receivers, and the result is a long touchdown run. 66 yards, I believe.
Texas City going for two, and he's in. Deshaun Rawls is in for the two-point conversion. Big 2 points to give Texas City the seven-point lead. We'll take the break with 10:28 to play in the first half. Texas City takes the lead back 19-12. Texas City ready to kick off. Aaron Clays puts the foot into it. Kick's going to be taken at the 20-yard line. It's Alexander with the ball, waiting for some tacklers, and he'll finally go down at the 35.
Short kick that time. Alexander able to field it on the run.
Colin Abernathy on the stop for Texas City and got an assist from Nathan Stahl, number 10. So the Patriots will take over. First and 10 at their own 36. So far, pretty much each team has answered the other with a scoring opportunity. Sting defense would like to change that.
Third and under center. Going to turn and hand it off to Montgomery. The first man three's got a lot of running room. Midfield, 45-40. He's still rumbling. Shakes off a tackler to the 20-15. And he's going to be finally dragged down.
Well, number two, Donald Lynch, went down at his feet. And he's not getting up very quick. What a good-looking run. He had a big hole in the quick opener.
Yeah, he busted that one all the way down to the 11-yard line. But it's very slow to get up. Great hustle by the secondary to finally close in and make a tackle. You mentioned Lynch down there. Touchdown saving tackle.
Have an injury timeout on the field, so we'll take the break as well. 10-11 to play in the first half. Stings on top, 19-12. First and 10 for the Patriots after the big run by Montgomery. He's helped off the field by a couple of his teammates.
Durden going to turn, fake the handoff and keeping himself on the right side. Running room, and he fumbles the ball. Bounces into the end zone.
They're going to call him down. I see one official is calling him down at the looks like the 1 yard line.
Yeah, it looks like he lost it as he was reaching for extra yardage. They'll mark him down just inside the 2 yard line, about a yard shy of the first down.
So second and one from the 2. For the Patriots trying to answer Texas City's last score.
Full house backfield this time for the Patriots. Two full backs and a tailback lined up behind Durden. He's going to turn and pitch it to the deep man. Ball's loose on the ground, but it looks like he was able to cover it.
Looks like just as he started to make his turn, is that number 32?
That's number 12, I believe.
12, okay.
Dante Allen.
Just as he started to make his cut, he lost his footing a little bit.
Actually, you know what? I think you might be right. Mitchell Hudson, 32. Kind of difficult to see those numbers.
Yeah. Lost a yard. It'll be third and 3.
Looks like they've got their jumbo package now in the backfield with Hudson. Taking the pitch, cuts it back inside, takes a hit, and he's going to drag a defender in for the touchdown.
Second effort, he got hit in the backfield, or just as he got to the line of scrimmage, but they couldn't stop him. He had his head of steam going, and the Patriots have answered with 6 points of their own.
Mitchell Hudson with the 2-yard touchdown run that time.
Four plays on that drive.
64-yard drive. Key play was the 53-yard run on the first play of the drive by Montgomery. They'll line up for the 2-point conversion this time. Durden will take the snap and drops back to pass, rolling out. He's going to loft it up, and it's going to be broken up and intercepted. Great job that time.
Avery Fuller, number 22, with the interception on the 2-point conversion. So Texas City holds on the lead. 8:19 to play in the first half. Stings on top, 19-18.
The trend.
To say it's been a crazy first half is a gross understatement. 19-18 after the Patriot touchdown, 2-point conversion to try to give them a lead is intercepted by Texas City's Avery Fuller. Now the Patriots ready to kick off.
Gondinas will tee it up. He's going to kick a pooch kick.
It's going to go way out of bounds. Hits the track. That one probably didn't go quite like they drew it up on the chalkboard.
Not quite the trajectory they were looking for.
All went out of bounds at about the 40-yard line.
Stings will get the opportunity to take the ball right there.
So that's right, Texas City will take it. They'll mark it off from where it went out of bounds. So Stings will start at their own.
Call it the 45.
Yeah, their own 45. Texas City offense ready to go. Two wideouts to either side. Deontay Foreman in the backfield. Andre Allen ready to go under center. Checks that defense. And, oh, nice play as Allen's got all kinds of running room. He's at the 30 and finally gets brought down from a guy that looks like he came off the bench. Yeah. I didn't even see him out there. And he stopped at the 26-yard line. Allen stands straight up from under center like he's going to throw the ball, pumps it, tucks it, and runs straight up the middle.
Yeah, it was a designed quick hitch there, but when nobody in front of you, you take off and tuck it and run.
So after the long game, first and 10 for Texas City from the 26 of the Patriots.
29-yard scramble that time.
Stings looking to get the right personnel on the field. Finally, everybody's ready. Again, two wideouts to either side. Allen under center. Looking to throw, fires it downfield. Oh, in and out of the hands of a Patriot. Threw it into coverage.
Mitchell Hudson, the man who scored the last touchdown for the Patriots, had nothing but green in front of him, thankfully, right through his hands. Brings up second down for the Stings.
Texas City holding on to that lead, looking to extend it. Second and 10 from the Patriot 26. Allen in the shack. So that's Armani Foreman in the Wildcat. He takes the snap, sees a hole, but it closes quickly, and he'll get to about the 22. Gain of four. So it'll be third and 6 for Texas City. Line of scrimmage, the 23.
Rawls and Deontay Foreman both checking back into the game here.
Only only 4 seconds on the clock. Texas City's going to call them a play clock. Texas City will call the timeout. We'll take the break as well with 7:02 to play in the first half. Stings on top, 19-18. Both teams back on the field and ready to go after the Texas City timeout. 3rd and 6 from the Patriot 23 for the Stingarees. Andrew Allen under center. Armani Foreman out wide to the near side. Allen with the handoff to Deontay Foreman. Gets hit in the backfield, keeps his feet, but he's not going anywhere. And it'll be maybe a 1 yard gain. No, well, a 1 yard loss at best.
Stings are probably in 4 down territory here. Too long for, well, maybe not. They're going to send
Aaron Clace.
Clace in.
Comes on to the field with the tee in hand. He'll put it down at the 30. It'll be a 40-yard attempt for Aaron Clace. Andrew Allen to hold. Hideo Hanlon doing the snapping center. Good snap. Hold is down. Kick is up. And it's going to be...
He might squeeze.
Good. Oh, he got it just inside the far upright. Aaron Clace with a 40-yard field goal for Texas City extends the lead for the Stings 22-18. We'll be back in just a second with the Stingaree kickoff.
Wow. Nice.
Aaron Clace set to kick off after his second field goal of the night. The first one 35 yards. This last one here, 40-yard field goal for Clace.
He's done a great job of sneaking it inside the upright both times. Pooch kick this time. Going to be taken at the 35, and the Stings deliver the ball.
Oh, flags coming in after the play. Not sure who that was that got the first hit for Texas City. I think it was Dalvin Jackson, number 32.
Looks like a great open field stop. They'll mark it at the 34, and we'll sort out the penalty.
Oh, big penalty against Texas City there. Dead ball, personal foul against the Stings.
Don't think they quite heard the whistle blowing on that one because they were getting after it quite a bit after the tackle was made.
So the Patriots will start at their own 49-yard line with just over 6 minutes to play in the first half. Texas City with the 6-point lead.
Dern will bring the offense back out on the field. 2 men in the backfield for him this time. He's going to turn and look to pass. Pass is going to be complete at the 45 in Texas City Sting territory. And that time, receiver number 8, Zane Verneil, hard to go down as he picks up 9 yards on the first down reception.
On the stop, Deshaun Rawls for Texas City. Make it 2nd and 1.
Turns and pitches. Alexander on the carry, got the first down. He carries ball down to the Texas City 37-yard line that time.
I believe that was Deshaun Rawls again on the stop. Chains move, 1st and 10 for the Patriots.
This time they break the huddle. Durden with the receivers near side here. He's going to turn and look to pass. Passes off the hands of Harris.
Intercepted. That's Texas City number 2. Donald Lynch comes up with the interception. Stingaree Bay football. It's baseball. I've been looking at Coach Cooper too much. Oh, nice job by Texas City as the ball is tipped up in the air. Lynch is right there to take it, and the Stings will take over at their own 26.
Great job on the field again. He had the first down reception for 9 yards just a few plays ago. That time off his fingertips, and Lynch capitalizes, gives the Stings an opportunity to play add-on.
Lynch will join Deshaun Rawls in the backfield. Andrew Allen under center. I'll get my tight end tongued here in a minute. Lynch.
He's got a lot of
Oh, he does. Flag comes in as he gets across the 40 to about the 43, but a flag not in a pretty place. Now it's going to be a legal block against Texas City.
Stings started throwing 26 this time, but that's going to back him up 10.
That'll put the line of scrimmage back inside the 20 at the 17, 18 yard line. Sting's ready to go. First and long, first and 20. Allen in the shotgun with wideouts to either side. Takes a drop. Got a man open looking for Foreman. Foreman's got it caught and down at the 47, 48-yard line. Nice job. Nice route by Foreman. Comes down and just cuts to the middle of the field. Allen waits on him and gets the pass right there where it needs to be. Stings, move the chains.
Great job up front, giving Allen plenty of time there to find the open man. Foreman came all the way from the outside, come across the middle on a dig route.
Under 4.5 minutes to play in the half. Allen under center. Rawls gets the call and nowhere to go as he gets wrapped up as he gets to the line of scrimmage.
Number 33 that time on the stop for the Patriots. No gain. Officially maybe a yard gain that time.
Second and little less than 10, we'll call it. Allen in the shotgun. Armani Foreman will go in motion. He'll get the
reverse.
Yep, there we go. We've got a blocker out in front, and that's Texas City's number 5, Adrian West, across the 30, and it'll go out of bounds at about the 25. We're going to mark it right at the 25-yard line. Nice job on the reverse. Armani Foreman gets the pitch from Allen, and then he gives it off to Adrian West coming from the far side. And the Stings move the chains again.
Good job again blocking downfield. That time, who was it leading the way?
Quarterback. How about that? Exactly. Love it.
Looked like Jim Kelly down there.
Yeah. Armani Foreman and Corey Johnson go out wide to the far side on first and 10 from the Patriot 25-yard line. Lynch and Deontay Foreman in the backfield. Lynch gets the call, breaks up as he sees a hole, breaks a tackle across the 15. Nice, tough run by Donald Lynch.
You know, the one thing that you see with each of these new backs that comes in, it's a change of pace. Each one has their own different unique style.
Exactly.
That time
good,
you
good
saw
point.
Lynch quick to the hole, very quick feet, and able to deliver the blow at the end there.
Yeah, that was a tough run. And gives Texas City another first down. And we've got a timeout on the field.
Goose Creek with the timeout.
We'll take the break as well. 3:21 to play in the first half. Stings on top, 22-18. Both teams back on the field after the Patriot timeout. First and 10, Texas City at the Memorial 13-yard line. From the eye, Johnson comes in motion, a handoff. Not much there at all, if anything, for Donald Lynch. Going to give him the line of scrimmage.
Clock winding down to 3 minutes left here in the first half. Stings hoping to add to their lead here, and then they get the ball to start the second half.
Exactly.
So hoping for that 2-for-1.
Texas City back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10. Allen goes under center. Foreman out wide. Armani Foreman. 2 or 3 step drop and fires it up into the corner. Up for, we've got a flag on the play. It's intended for Armani Foreman, but I believe we're going to have pass interference in the end zone.
Yeah, the defender never turned around. He just kind of waved his arm, face guarding him. Defensive back, so that's a pretty easy call.
Oh, they called it against Texas City.
Wow.
Pass interference is called against Texas City. Wow. That's,
well, the old NFL replacement officials went to found their own home, right?
Now we know where they went.
Wow.
Tough break for the Stings. They've broken the huddle and ready to go, and officials haven't even marked off the penalty. That'll move the line of scrimmage back to about the 28-yard line. So it'll be second and long from the Patriots' 28-yard line. Allen under center has Deontay Foreman and Donald Lynch in the backfield. And we've got flags as the play tries to get underway.
Yeah, we jumped early that time. Right side of the line.
Against Texas City, it'll back it up five more.
Things not moving in the right direction for the Stings now, so they ought to buckle down, try to play with a little more discipline.
Second and long, let's call it. Line of scrimmage to 33. They can get a first down at the 3. So you can figure that one out. I don't even want to say it. Allen under center. And we've got flags again. Offsides against Baytown this time as the referee was marking it off against Texas City. Oh, and now he said, oh, okay, well, yeah, I guess it was against them. Oh, my.
More referee scandals than one week than you can shake a stick at.
Here we go. Third and, or second and even longer now for Texas City from the Patriot 38. Allen takes the drop back, looking to throw, fires it upfield and into traffic. Intended receiver is number 83. That's Tate Smith. But the ball's incomplete.
Allen didn't see him, but he had Foreman, Armani Foreman, wide open down the right sideline.
That'll bring up third and long for Texas City. This might just be a hair out of Aaron Clace's field goal range here. This would be about a 50-yarder, close to it. But we're not there yet. From the shotgun, Allen has plenty of time. Now he's going to just take it and run. Gets away from one. He's across the 20. Gets cut from behind 15 down to the 17. Goes Andrew Allen.
He's really close to the original line of scrimmage.
He is. Well, what's that, about a 25-yard gain?
Yes, he got us right back into field goal.
Just what you wanted, that's right.
Range, you know, here for Clayson.
And it's Clayson. They'll set the tee down at the 22. It'll be a 32-yard attempt for Clayson. Snap is up. Kick is plenty long enough. And it's good. Aaron Clace with his third field goal of the night extends Texas City's lead 25-18 with a minute 40 left to play in the first half. We'll be right back with Texas City kickoff. Aaron Clace, the Aaron Clace show tonight. After his third field goal, he's set to kick off. This one will be short, hits the ground. And picked up, coming to the near side, looking for some running room, runs into a couple of black jerseys, and he'll finally go down. Believe that was number 3, Joseph Lewis, on the carry.
Down that first for the Stings was Avery Fuller. Slowed him down enough to have his teammates come help him out there.
So the Patriots will start at their own 32-yard line with 91 seconds left in the first half. Both teams have one timeout left.
That last scoring drive for the Stings, 9 plays, 69 yards when you count in the 10-yard penalty on the first play, ended with a 32-yard field goal by Clace. Durden takes the shotgun snap, has lots of time, but then he starts to run out. He'll take a big hit that time and delivers the ball.
Looked like he couldn't decide whether to throw it or not, and he stuttered just for a minute, and as he threw it, Devontae Hinton put a hit on him. He'll remember number 6's imprint on his chest as he goes to the locker room here in a minute.
Yeah, that was a great job that time. Good pressure by the Stings. Didn't give him a lot of time there. Durden will stay in the shotgun formation. He's got Alexander in the backfield with him this time. Dropping back to pass, got pressure again.
Oh,
and he throws again. This time Deontay Foreman
was right in the quarterback's face as he threw it, and Avery Fuller, if he'd have looked up a second earlier, had a touchdown written all over the interception that he could have had, but just didn't see the ball. He was headed to the receiver. Pass falls incomplete, stops the clock with a minute 20 to play in the second quarter. It'll be third and 10 for the Patriots.
Stings have a good opportunity here. If they can stop them on third down, one timeout left, try to get one more score before the half. Defense has to do their job first, though. Durden will take the shotgun snap. Going to roll out to this near side. Hit.
Nothing doing.
Football. The ball is out. Patriots will fall on it.
Deontay Foreman smelled that one out from the minute the ball was snapped and had the hit on.
They're going to call forward progress stopped at the 25. But nonetheless, Stings are going to get the ball back here. They'll go ahead and take a timeout right now to preserve the last minute and 8 before this punt.
Nice job by the Stingaree defense that time. We'll just stay with it right here as we've got a minute and 8 seconds left to play. During this timeout, Texas City's defense just did a yeoman's job that time, didn't it, Jim?
Yeah, 3 plays, negative 7 yards that time as the Sting defense had pressure on each of the 3 plays. Never had an opportunity to get off the passes on the first 2 downs, and then that time they swallowed up Alexander as soon as he got the ball.
Like you said, Texas City's going to have another shot at it, a minute 8 left. They'll have obviously probably under a minute with which to play with before the half is over and try to extend that 25-18 lead. Armani Foreman standing back inside his own 40-yard line.
Alexander back to punt. Actually,
high kick, but it's short. It's going to hit at the Texas City 45, Texas Stingaree row. It'll be down. Texas City's going to have some pretty nice field position, first and 10 at the Patriots 46-yard line.
Great opportunity for the Stings here. As Andrew Allen will lead the Stings out, first down and 10, going with the 2-minute drill here. Ball at the 46-yard line of the Patriots. Allen will take the snap. Rolls out to his right and drops it off to the 40, 35, 30, 25. Still on his feet is Armani Foreman. He's still going. Armani Foreman's going to carry it into the end zone.
Looking for any other officials. Nobody's calling anything.
There's
a flag. I see the flag now. What a great run by Armani Foreman. Stayed on his feet. And I believe that one's going to come back.
They had him dead to rights at about the 20-yard line. He pulled a little pirouette move out, took it into the end zone, but it's going to come back a little bit here, if not a lot.
Wow. That was huge.
Yeah, it looks like there was a block downfield, so it'll be a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Texas A will have the first down at the Goose Creek 26-yard line.
With 46.1 seconds.
So a net gain of 20 yards negates the touchdown, but Sting's able to run it up to the line of scrimmage real quick. Allen sends a man in motion.
From the shotgun, Allen has got some time, fires it downfield now, caught by Foreman, Armani Foreman, inside the 15 at about the 13-yard line. Again, no timeouts left, but they'll stop the clock while they move the chains. Well, no, it's not a first down.
It is a first down, they're going to...
Yeah, okay, now I see the chains moving. I was going to say, well, the clock did stop. I looked up and there were no chain gang moving, but now they're ready. From under center, Allen takes a snap and fires the ball to the ground to stop the clock with 36.4 seconds. Texas City first. It'll be second and 10 at the Patriot 14-yard line, 13-yard line, looking to put another one in. Boy, Jim, just like you talked about, what a huge set of events would take place if Texas City could put some more points on the board, then get the ball back to start the second half.
Yeah, nice swing of momentum there as they thought they would have an opportunity maybe to stop Memorial without coming down for a score. And don't think they had in mind that they would get it back with a good opportunity
right.
to score,
right.
such as they did.
Sting's ready to go. Two wideouts to either side. Deshaun Rawls is the lone man in the backfield as Andrew Allen is under center.
Spread them out, run it up the middle. Well.
Oh, nice catch. Oh, nice. Just on the look in, number nine, Zach Powell.
Clock will stop as they get the first down.
Zach Powell makes a nice catch just on a little slant. And it'll be first and 10. Still 30 seconds left to play Texas City at the 2-yard line.
They'll probably run the play. Nope, he's going to clock it.
Yep, he is going to throw it down and stop the clock with 27 seconds. It'll be second down, second in goal from the 2.
Coach Cervic wanted the clock play that time so he can get his goal line package in.
And that's what he's got. He'll have Deontay Foreman and Colby Johnson joins them in the backfield. Andrew Allen under center. Double tight end set. Foreman gets the call, gets hit in the backfield, but pulls him forward for...
They're going to have to hurry
about
now.
A 1-yard gain. That's right. We're down to 18 seconds and counting. Remember, they can't stop the clock. Allen takes the snap and throws it down. That'll stop the clock with 10.9 seconds to play in the half.
Only problem is now that brings up fourth down, so you're probably going to have to go for the field goal at this point. Big choice here for Coach Cervic and his coaching staff.
That'll give them some time. Boy, yeah, this is a big decision for them. Do you take the 3 points, or do you go for it from the 2-yard line?
Ronnie, I don't know. I don't want to be conservative, but anytime you got a chance to put points on the board, I think you got to take it.
You know, that's what I was thinking too, Jim. You're exactly right. It's hard to not take those points, and it's not like Aaron Clace has not done his job. He's already got 3 field goals to his credit tonight.
Sometimes you feel real good about what you guys have done up front, feel like they can get you that 2 yards into the end zone, so looking more and more like they're going to go for the end zone. Field goal puts you up by 2 scores. A lot of different scenarios to think through here.
Patriots back on the field, Sting still in their huddle. And you're right, Jim, they're going to go for it. Armani Foreman will go out wide to the far side. Too wide to the near side. Deontay Foreman to the left of Andrew Allen, who will be in the shotgun.
I think it's going to be a quick pitch to Foreman here. See if he can outrun the defense.
Slant inside is caught by Armani Foreman. Nice job. Allen takes it, just fires it on the slant from the outside. Nice job, Armani Foreman hauls it in. Sure-handed Foreman puts 6 points on the board for Texas City. Big, big touchdown with 7 seconds to go in the half.
Yeah, gutsy call, but great play call that time. You know, you got your best wide receiver lined up out there, and you think that he can beat his man one-on-one. That's what they did. Allen was able to deliver the ball exactly where it needed to be, and That is a big play for this team.
Oh, I'm telling you. Aaron Clay set to attempt the extra point. Good snap. Hold us down. Kick us up. And it is good with 7.4 seconds to play in the first half. Texas City extends the lead 32-18 over the Goose Creek Memorial Patriots. We'll take a break and be right back. Aaron Clay set to kick off. Texas City just extended their lead 32-18. We were just talking about the break, Jim. What a gutsy call. Fourth and two. No timeouts left. 7 seconds left on the clock. And boom, it works for you. Big play by Texas City.
Yeah, you got to think coach was saying, hey, you know what? We're going to trust our playmakers. And if nothing else, we get the ball first to start the second half. Short kickoff. Ball carrier is going to be taken down by the Stings, and that'll end. Well, not quite.
Avery Fuller on the stop.
Couple seconds left here.
He made that tackle just a little bit too quick, huh?
Yeah.
So the Patriots will get probably one shot at it. See if they'll take a knee or if they'll take a shot at it. You can bet the Stingarees, and you can already see they've got four guys back deep. So from their own 31-yard line.
Durden will have two men in the backfield with him. You'll see if he'll try to air out or just take a knee. He'll turn and toss. That's going to be Alexander trying to find room on the wide side. He does and picks up a first down, but it's going to be dragged down, and that'll end the first half.
So that's the end of the first half. Texas City and Goose Creek Memorial Patriots have fought it out. Stings on top 32-18. Don't go away. Halftime entertainment is coming up next. Back onto the field, the Memorial Patriots from Baytown, Goose Creek, Independent School District are back on the field as well, 32-18. Jim, what a half that was. I'm worn out just from writing stuff down, and I'm not sure I got half of it.
Yeah, you know, it had a little bit of everything for the football fan out there. Obviously, coaches probably are nails down to the nub, but
exactly.
What the Stings really did well was right after they had that 19-18 lead as the Patriots, you know, cut down into their lead. They really took over the last 5 or 6 minutes of the second quarter, and they got field goal, touchdown, turnovers playing a big key, defense really stepping up big, and the offense making plays when they had to.
Boy, they sure did, and it was a crazy first couple of drives for both teams as the Patriots started out, 57-yard run for a touchdown, missed the extra point, 6-0. Texas City comes back with a nice, a three-play drive. They score, missed their extra point, 6-6. Then Aaron Clay hits a 35-yard, after a turnover by the Patriots, Aaron Clay has a 35-yard field goal to put Texas City up 9-6. And then Texas City fumbles, the Patriots pick it up and go 36 yards for the touchdown to make it, see, that made it
12-9,
that's right. And then their extra point was blocked and returned 85 yards for Texas City for the 2 points to make it 12-11. That's when it got crazy. Then Texas City comes back, 66-yard pass to Rawls to put Texas City up 19-11. Then the Patriots scored a touchdown, missed the extra point, made it 19-18. Then it's what took over where you talked about. Texas City came out, 40-yard field goal, his second of the night, 40-yard field goal for Clay. As the second half is underway, Texas City had a ball go through their legs and quickly recovered there. Nice Trace Rodriguez quickly falls on it, and Texas City will take over first and 10 from their own 32. That pretty much did it. Well, he had the 40-yard field goal to make it 22-18. Then Clay's came back with a 32-yard field goal to make it 25-18. And then right there at the end of the half, Texas City puts seven on the board, 32-18, and that's where we're at to start the second half.
And, you know, talked about it near the end of the first half. They get an opportunity now to go 2-for-1 here, where they get the ball first, pretty good field position to start their first drive here. They'll get ball at their own 32-yard line.
Andrew Allen under center, wideouts to either side, Rawls and Deontay Foreman in the backfield as Colby Johnson goes in motion to that far side. The pitch goes to Rawls. He cuts it up. Still got some room as he crosses the 40 to the 41. Nice 9-yard run for Deontay Foreman on first down for Texas City.
And it was really the 1-2 punch early on of Rawls and Deontay Foreman. And then end of the first half, it was the Armonte Foreman show as he had a couple of really nice plays, had a touchdown called back, and then ended up getting the touchdown catch to close out the first half.
Second and one for the Stings. Rawls from under center. Foreman gets the call again. He's got the first down and more, crosses midfield and just barrels over a tackler that finally brings him down, but not till he crosses the 40 to the 39-yard line. Nice, tough run by Rawls. Had a big hole to go through again. Nice job by that front line.
Yeah, great job opening up the holes, but we saw a couple times in the first half, Texas City Sting running backs really finishing the run, delivering that punishing blow at the end. They're not going to be taken down very easily.
First and 10 for the Stings. Allen checks that defense, and now Kobe gets a little extra head start, and the flags come out, so they'll back it up. Allen was checking that defense. That'll move the line of scrimmage back to the 44-yard line.
If there was one thing that plagued the Stings or didn't go their way in the first half, it was the penalty, so looking to minimize that here in the second half. Hand off again to Foreman. He's going to drag the
ball. Still got a couple of blockers still in front of him, and he'll get the first down and some more all the way down to the 25-yard line.
Wow. Bouncing off of would-be tacklers, and out front, big number 73, Jacob Stanley, leading the charge, 6'1", 280 pounds, and he was just moving people. Looked like they had him on skates that time.
Stings move the chains. 26-yard line now, line of scrimmage, first and 10 from there. Armonte Foreman goes out wide to the far side. Colby Johnson in motion goes that way as well. And Foreman gets the call again. Another big hole across the 15-10. And down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line goes Deontay Foreman.
17 yards again, and he's picking up yardage in big clips.
You know, it's almost like they started the first half, Jim, in that first quarter. It was Deontay Foreman every play. Next time they got the ball, they switched it around. Deshaun Rawls took his turn. So a little bit of the same for Texas City as they come out of the halftime locker room.
It's nice to have that many talented skill position players, and you can just kind of pick your poison, right?
I'm telling you. Coach Cervic and his staff had to be licking their chops when they came in, just waiting to see what would happen. Allen, under center, Foreman again, another big hole as he hits the 5-yard line and stood up there by a defender. He'll gain 4.
Brought down that time, looks like number 44. Darius Montgomery on the stop.
No, spotted just inside the 5, so it'll be second and goal.
Check that, number 84, Travis Coslow on the stop for the Patriots.
Rawls and Foreman. Foreman gets the call again, steps over a tackler, gets down to about the one, and is stopped there. They're going to mark it at the two.
Costello again on the stop, but nice pickup of three on the second down carry there.
That'll be third and goal for the Stings. From the two, Corey Johnson brings a play in from the sideline, and he'll go out wide to the far side. Allen, under center. Deontay Foreman gets the call again. He's got it. Touchdown, Texas City, on the opening drive of the second half.
That's the way that you impose your will. When you're a dominant football team, you just line up and do what you do best.
Just got to say, we're going to hand it off to this guy. Stop us.
That's right. If it's not broke, don't try to fix
Absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. Aaron Clay set to attempt the extra point. Hanlon with the snap. Good snap. Hold us down by Andrew Allen, and Clay's kick is up and good. So with 8:24 to play in the third quarter, Texas City extends their lead 39-18 over the Patriots. Aaron Clay's to kick off for Texas City after the very impressive opening drive of the second half for Texas City. Eight plays, and Foreman capped off with a Foreman touchdown. What did we say, 64 yards?
68 yards.
68 yards. Place his kick short, taken at the 35-yard line, and he goes down at the 37, maybe a couple of yards, as Nathan Stahl, as well as Francois Bonilla on the stop for the Stings.
Malik Michael was the up man that returned that this kick.
The Patriots will start at their own 38-yard line.
And DeAndre Durden will start this half, their first drive on offense under center. He's going to turn, fake the handoff, and keep it himself. Now he's going to pitch to Alexander. Got lots of running room. First down and more down inside Sting territory, where they'll finally run him out at about the 34-yard line. But a big pickup there on the first down by Shondre Alexander.
Well, it was finally forced out of bounds by Texas City's number 17, Dominique Allen.
Yard carry on the first down, but we look like we've got a penalty on the field.
Yeah, holding against the Patriots, missed that flag. And that'll negate the big run.
Yeah, it looked like it was downfield, so it's 10 yards from the spot of the foul. They'll get the first down.
Line of scrimmage will be the 43, so it'll be first and five from the Texas City 43.
Third and under center. He'll turn, keep it himself after the fake. He's got another first down. Running room down deep in the Sting territory as he crosses the 30-yard line. We'll mark him down there.
Donald Lynch on the stop for Texas City.
Patriots. Patriots just going back to basics there with that option play, faking the handoff to the fullback, and then quarterback gets the run pitch option there.
Chris Gray also on the stop for Texas City. First and 10 for the Patriots from the Texas City 30-yard line.
Durden will turn and pitch to Alexander. Alexander going to be wrapped up in the
nice
back.
Nice job. I believe the first man there fought off his block. Very nice. And number 22, Avery Fuller. Then got some help from his friends to bring him down. And put it, that was number 34, Corey Robinson.
Good penetration that time as the Stings dropped the Patriots for a loss of one.
in that first quarter, both teams just took turns scoring. I'd like to not see that now, but at least Texas City's got a leg up if that is going to happen.
That's right. They were also able to utilize a little bit of time off that clock in that first drive.
That's exactly right.
Third and under center. Now going to call a timeout.
We'll take the break as well. 6:36 to play in the third quarter. Texas City on top of the Memorial Patriots, 39-18.
DeAndre Durden will line the Patriot offense up. Second down and 11 from the Stingaree 31-yard line. Durden's going to take it himself up the middle. He's got a lot of room. He's going to walk right into the end zone. 31-yard touchdown run on the quarterback keeper by DeAndre Durden.
Boy, the sea parted, and there was nothing in front of him but white stripes. And Durden takes it in for 6.
You got to think that he saw something right away, because there was no hesitation, no pullback or anything. He was straight ahead, full speed. And we've got Godinez lining up for the extra point attempt. Snap is down, kick is up, and it is good as the Patriots pull closer to Stings. 6:29 left in the third quarter. Stings up 39-25.
Well, just like what we said we didn't want to happen was the Patriots, the Memorial Patriots. You know, it's such a long name. It's just the Baytown Goose Creek Memorial Patriots. And I don't know which one to say. But anyway, the Patriots have answered Texas City's score. Like you said, though, Jim, in the break, the nice part about Texas City's score was they took some time off the clock this time. So we're already down to under halfway through. We're past halfway mark of the third quarter. 6:29 to play in the third.
That drive only taking 4 plays to go 62 yards. The 31-yard touchdown run by Durden as the Stings take the kickoff here. Field it at about the 32. And taking the corner there.
That's not Donald Lynch. That's Adrian West. West does a good job, scoots it up like a good shortstop would from the far side and brings it to the near side, finds some blockers, and gets it into Patriot territory. Texas City will start 1st and 10 at the Patriot 42-yard line.
Yeah, nice job that time of reversing field and coming all the way back across. Got some good blocks and nice field position to start their second drive of the second half.
Andrew Allen brings the team straight to the line of scrimmage. He'll be under center with Deontay Foreman and Deshaun Rawls in the eye. Rawls gets the call on the left side. Stiff arms away from one would-be tackler. He's got the corner, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10. He changes directions and touchdown, Texas City.
Wow. Great job that time. Field vision. He set up the defenders to make them look really foolish that time after he outran most of the defense. He had two guys to beat, juked one way and juked one the other way, and 42 yards to the end zone.
Nice job by Texas City. Well, you like to score about any time. We talked about them taking time off the clock. That didn't take a lot of time off the clock, but that's okay. You put 6 points on the board. Now we have
an injury.
I'm sorry. I see that he's over on the far sideline. It's a Patriot that's down. So we'll take the timeout as well. Injured player from the sideline for the Patriots gets up and walks to the bench on his own. Now the extra point to come. Andrew Allen, the hold. Good snap. Hold is down. Kick is up. And Texas City adds another point to the lead with 6:06 to play here in the third quarter. Texas City 46, Memorial Patriots 25. Clay's ready to kick off. After the 42-yard touchdown run by Deshaun Rawls, this one hits the ground at about the 25-30-yard line. It is live, and boy, just barely gone. And there comes a flag in play. As both teams were headed for the loose ball.
That's a weak call.
Well, well said. Recovered at the 21-yard line, but they're gonna throw the flag for a late hit as the Stingaree was still going for the ball. Mark it off from the 22.
You know, it's one thing when the intent is there, but when it's just aggressive play, you know, you can't really fault the guys for thinking that they're jumping on a live ball there.
So Texas City has had the ball twice in the second half, has scored a touchdown both times. Patriots have had it once and scored a touchdown. Now here on their second time with the ball, let's try to break this trend.
Durden back under center. He's going to turn and toss it to Alexander. Alexander's not going to have a lot of room there.
Fumble on the ground. Colby Johnson was there. And he's saying that the runner was down.
Wow.
Whoa. They're going to mark it back up at the line of scrimmage.
That's a quick whistle.
Yes, it was. I agree with you, my friend. Colby Johnson made the initial hit.
Nonetheless, it'll be stopped for a no gain or a minimal loss. Yeah, very, very quick whistle that time. Saying his forward progress was stopped. Durden will line up now with two men in the backfield. Two men split to the near side here. He'll turn, fake the handoff, and keep it himself. Not going to find a lot of running room, but he stumbles forward for about a gain of four.
It's like Devontae Hinton, Adrian West in on the stop.
Brings up third down to go for the Patriots. Near the 5-minute mark here in the third quarter. And, you know, for the third time in 4 weeks, or four games this year, and the Stings have now gone over 40 points, the high-flying Stings this year.
There you go, putting the points on the board.
Durden turns, fakes the handoff. He's going to drop back a pass. Finds a man for the reception, and it's going to be good enough for a first down.
Immediately brought down by Deshaun Rawls, number 21. But, like Jim said, not before they pick up the needed yardage to move the chains.
That time back in the ballgame making the reception is Darius Montgomery, fullback.
Good to see him. Well, glad he's back. It's not good as a Stingaree fan to see him back, but glad to see him back on the field.
We wish him well, just not too well.
Absolutely. Every other week this year.
We wish him health.
Yeah.
First down now at the Sting 48-yard line. Durden's going to turn, fake the handoff. It's going to be a reverse.
On the ground.
Loose again. And lucky to be able to jump back on that.
Adrian West was almost in the middle of that pitch. Kind of interrupted it just enough for the ball to be on the ground, but the Patriots able to recover it.
Yeah, Durden that time made the pitch right to Kobe Shoemaker, but hit him in the breadbasket. He lucky that he got back on that one. Loss of about 4 yards. We'll call it 5 yards. It'll be a second down and 15. Durden will call out the signals now. Going to fake the handoff. He's going to roll out the pass. Pass is caught by number 45. Good for the first down. 17-yard reception that time from Durden to Don Rittenhouse.
Rawls on the stop for Texas City.
Patriots not known to throw the ball a lot, but that time Durden was effective on the rollout. First down and 10 now for the Patriots at the Sting 36-yard line. And Durden will turn and pitch it to Alexander. Alexander had running room initially, but swallowed up quickly that time by the Texas City defense. Devontae Hinton.
Hinton did a nice job of fighting off his blocker, pushing him away and making the stop. Nice job.
Yeah, that hole looked like it opened up but just as quickly as it did, Hinton shut it down in a hurry.
And that's a sophomore, Hinton.
Second down and 8 for the Patriots. Durden taking his time, calling out the signals. He's going to turn the handoff. Now he's going to keep it himself. And lots of traffic in the backfield.
Colby Johnson makes the tackle, but if he would have handed off, Dalvin Jackson might have been the closest man for Texas City to receive that handoff, yeah, as he was in the face of the running back.
Jackson getting good pressure, and along with the rest of the Sting defensive front that time. Big stop there, brings up a long third down. Third and 8 for the Patriots. Durden will fake the toss, drops back to pass, and swings it out. Errant pass that time. Intended receiver was Zane Vanille, and he had a little bit of room out there.
He did. He had some green in front of him and the nearest Stingaree defender.
Yeah, Durden just rushed that throw that time. He never set his feet. And errant throw brings up a fourth down. Yeah, that's going to be fourth down in a punting situation.
Is this the first punt of the night?
I believe the Stings have punted once.
Okay.
And I believe the Patriots have punted once.
I knew there hadn't been many of them.
Kick is off, and they'll try to pin them deep in their own territory. Ball will bounce and be spotted down at the 14-yard line, but there is a penalty flag thrown.
Doesn't look good for Texas City. Personal foul against the Stings.
We'll see if it was a dead ball personal foul or if it was during the play. I know the flag was thrown pretty late there. Looks like Sting offense is going to come out on the field, so it was on the change of possession. So it'll be half the distance back to the goal line. The good news is Stings do take possession of the ball. Bad news is they're backed up inside their 10-yard line to start this next drive.
At their own 7 is where Texas City will start with a minute 40 to play in the third quarter. Texas City on top 46-25.
Time for an Armonte Foreman 93-yard touchdown, I think.
That doesn't sound too bad.
Allen back to pass. He's got Foreman deep. Ball's caught.
Could it be?
Oh! Oh no, he fumbled!
Oh, tough break for Foreman. The Patriots are going to get it. It's going to be at about the 2-yard line. What a great pass from Andrew Allen on the money to Armonte Foreman. Almost like they heard you. He had that 93-yard touchdown pass. But he got caught at about the 10 and just coughed it up.
Yeah, great pass, great catch right in stride. Got to wrap that ball up, though. Defender was able to come and strip it away. Good news out of that is that the Stains defense gets a chance to maybe get on the board themselves here as they back the Patriot offense up to their own 2-yard line. Not very often that you're disappointed with an 80-yard reception, right?
Yeah, really. The Patriots start, like Jim said, at their own 3.
Durden under center. He's got to drop back, quick throw. Ball is scooped up off the ground.
Yep.
Nope, they're going to say incomplete. Good call that time. As intended receiver again was Vernil. He had a little bit of running room, but Durden on the throw again.
The last pass to him was over his head. This one was at his cleats.
Yeah. Not very easy to set up and throw when you've got a lot of pressure in your face like that.
Well, exactly, and you're standing in the end zone or right at the goal line anyway. 2nd and 10 now for the Patriots.
third and they'll survey the defense. Up under center now. And it looks like Stings will... It's going to be a rush up the middle. Penalty flags come in late. Going to be a personal foul face mask against the Stings. So that's going to add on 15 more yards as Patriots now get out of the shadow of their own goalpost. It'll be a first down after the 15-yard mark off.
The gain was to the 8. And with the penalty yards added on, it's going to put the line of scrimmage at the 23. Patriots at their own 23. Right at 1 minute to play here in the third quarter.
That was a big penalty. Yeah. When you get a guy down like that, you can't let him back up. So Sting's defense had their work cut out, and it's a handoff. Second man through. Alexander can be dropped after a minimal gain. Pickup of about 2 on that play.
Mike Petty, number 38, one of the first ones, senior linebacker there for Texas City, along with Avery Fuller.
And that time, Alexander come up a little gingerly. Something to watch for.
Not sure the Patriots will run a play. 15 seconds and counting. Play clock hasn't even been started yet.
Nope, they're going to go ahead and run it out.
Yep, that's going to do it for the third quarter. As we get ready to start the fourth and final, Texas City on top of the Memorial Patriots, 46-25. We'll be back with the fourth quarter action in just a second. To the rig to take on the Dawson Eagles from Pearland.
Third now with the Patriots under center. He's going to drop back and pass. Quick pass out to Verniel, but he doesn't have a lot of running room that time.
Avery Miller shuts it down pretty quick. I'm sorry, Avery Fuller shuts it down pretty quick.
Good open field tackle that time. What they're just trying to do out there is get their speedy receiver out in space and try to make a man miss, turn it into a big play, but Fuller wasn't having any of that. Third down and 4. From their own 30-yard line. Durden sets the offense with 2 receivers to the near side, 2 men in the backfield with him. He's going to turn and pitch it, and runners stopped initially and finally dragged down. Great job that time.
Colby Johnson got a hold of some jersey and wouldn't let go.
Johnson not having any of that. Running back looked to maybe be slipping away, but Johnson yanked him back and slung him down. Fourth down in a punting situation for the Patriots. Armonte Foreman back for the Stings to receive, standing at his own 36-yard line. High snap, but the punter gets it off. It's going to be high and short, landing at about the Sting 45, and it takes a Sting-friendly bounce where it's going to be downed at their 46-yard line. Stings will have great field position to start this next drive.
Yes, they will. At their own 46.
Yeah, the Stings have really controlled this game from just a little bit past midway in the second quarter. You like to see them finish strong. Touchdown here pretty much sends most of the crowd home.
I think that would be just what the doctor ordered. Probably Coach Cervic would order that as well. From under center, Andrew Allen, handoff to Deontay Foreman. He's got a hole, crosses the 45 down to the 41-yard line goes Foreman.
Upended there by number 20, Malik Michael. But not before Foreman picks up first down yardage. That's another Also like to see them work some clock down here.
That would be nice. Well, it'd be a short drive, but it could make it a short long drive, huh? Foreman gets the call again. He's hit at the line of scrimmage and fights for a couple of yards to the 39.
If I had to guess, I think you're going to get a heavy dose of Deontay Foreman.
We really appreciate you joining us here on these rebroadcasts, both on Comcast Stingaree TV as well as YouTube. Pass along to your friends that you can go to YouTube.com and find every Stingaree game this year. If you don't have Comcast, they'll be there within a couple of days after the ball game. And now we've got time called by Texas City with 9:20 to play in the half. We're going to keep it here because I want to tell you a big shout out and a big thanks. These broadcasts are brought to you by the sponsors that you see, the credits that roll at the first of the game on YouTube. And we appreciate those folks and helping them bring the broadcast to you. But it wouldn't be possible without the video tech class, their instructor, Darrell Hannes, and all the students that are running the film crews and everything that they do. And they include tonight Alyssa Keithley. Ryan Higgins is a former staff member with the group working tonight. Marissa Solis, Jeffrey Brown, Kyle Cornelius, David Wilson, Alex Garza, Dara Galloway, Roy Mills. Appreciate those folks and all the work that they do with cameras up here in the press box and cameras down the field. Great job by Coach Hannes. We'll call him Coach Hannes, but Mr. Hannes and all the students, and they work tirelessly. Every time the scoreboard comes on, these guys are here with the cameras.
Yeah, you can see them working down hard on the field, hard in the booth next to us. Great job by all.
Back to the action, second and 8 for Texas City. Andrew Allen looking for somebody to throw to, throws it to Deshaun Rawls here in the flats. He stapes a couple of tackles, still on his feet, looking for his blockers, and gets down to the 20-yard line. Wow, nice run.
He just did that all on his own there. He had guys that had him dead to rights several times, and he just dances out of it. Great job there.
And it's good to see that you join in the ranks with Dennis and I. If whatever we say, we'd like to see what we're going to get a big dose of running. What do they do first time after that? They throw the ball.
Yeah, great job there. Run after catch. You know, it's big when you always great to have those running backs that can run the ball, but when they have the ability to catch the ball also out of the backfield, double threat.
Absolutely. Allen from under center on first down. Deontay Foreman gets the call, and he'll lose a couple. Ball's on the ground. Now they're going to call it down. Yeah, ground calls that one, so it'll be second for Texas City. A loss of, call it one, second and 11 for the Stings. Next home game, October 12th, big game, as we've said they all are, but that one will be the Friendswood game, and it's throwback game. The school district and everybody that the athletic department asking everybody to dig into your closet, find that oldest Texas City t-shirt or shirt that you have, and wear it to the game. Excuse me, wear those old t-shirts and jerseys, and somebody will be roaming through the stands to see who's got the oldest, I guess, classic jersey and could win some prizes with that. Andrew Allen fakes the handoff. On second and 12, looking to throw. He does fire it. Oh, just tipped as he saw an open man in at about the 5, which was Adrian West.
Yeah, just a little behind the receiver. You know, going back to that throwback, I'd be willing to put money that Dennis Johns might pull out, you know, something out of his closet like an old afro or a headband or something
from,
like
from
that.
From back when he was in high school,
yeah.
He might not have been here, but he's been here long enough in Texas City that it just might be right. Anything he had from Texas City from when he first came here, that was a good 20 years ago, so it would be vintage, right?
That's right.
Third and long for the Stings. Allen from the shotgun takes a snap, getting a rush now. Armani Foreman with the catch at about the 15 or 16, and that's about as far as he'll go.
Yeah, Foreman was dragging across the field. He was open, waving his hands as much as he could. I tell you, if Allen would have found him a split second earlier, he might have been able to turn that up for a touchdown. As it is, it'll be a fourth and somewhat manageable. Stings do not bring the kicking unit on just yet.
Nope, don't see that happening right now. Said it's 4th and 6.
Now they do.
Here comes Clace. he will be set down at about the 22, so it'll be a 32, make that a 33-yard field goal for Aaron Clace.
It'll be a well-deserved day off tomorrow for Clace. Maybe some time in the whirlpool. Kick is up. It's good.
Nice job. That's his fourth field goal of the night, the 32-yarder by Aaron Clace to extend the lead for Texas City 49-25 with 7:06 to play in the game. We'll be right back with a kickoff. Aaron Clace to kick off after his fourth field goal of the night. Pooch kick on the ground is at about the 35, but quickly covered up by a white jersey. That's where the Patriots will set up camp at their own 35.
Good job of coverage that time. Clace able to get that ball up high, give his team an opportunity to get down and cover. Just 7 minutes, 5 seconds left. Stings with a comfortable lead, 49-25 now. Looking to close it out, pick up the first district victory of the year. Third and under center, gonna fake the toss, then he hands it off. Second man through is going to pick up good yardage out over the first down marker. He's going to pick up 11 on the first down carry.
Avery Fuller on the stop for the Stings. Also failed to mention, for all the district games this year, Texas City will have an elementary student chosen as the honorary captain. Tonight's honorary captain was Kenneth Brown, a fourth grader from Cofelt Elementary. Neat deal they do, let the kid, one of the students from elementary school and go out with for the coin toss. Pretty cool.
Good job, Kenneth. Future Stingaree.
There you go.
Durden will fake the handoff, keep it himself, and he's going to be buried in the
absolutely. First one there is, I believe that's, number 22, Avery Fuller. He has had a great ball game tonight, called his number quite a few times.
Yeah, swallowed him up there. They're going to call forward progress. Only about a yard, loss of one, but that's a favorable spot. But nonetheless, we'll take it. Second down and 11. Durden with new running backs in the backfield behind him. He's got trip receivers to the near side. He's going to step back, fire it out. Ball caught. And a modest gain, 3 yards that time. Pass reception made by Kobe Shoemaker.
Chris Gray, number 15, the first Stingaree there on the stop.
Stings closed very quickly on that as Durden was on target this time, but the defense closed in very, very quickly. Held him to a 3-yard gain. Patriots now 3rd down and 8. 3rd under center. He'll take the snap and drop back to pass. Hit as he throws and ball is tipped and caught. Running room for the receiver all the way backfield, across the field. And he's going to make it down to the 20-yard line. Second straight reception by Kobe Shoemaker. That time he able to tip the ball to himself and elude the tackler. Cuts all the way across the grain again and down to the 20-yard line. So first down for the Patriots.
Deontay Foreman makes the stop. Not sure that the Texas City defender over there with the pass was caught and knew the ball was tipped up in the air. Looked like he lost sight of it for a second. Able to make the reception, then he comes across the field. Deontay Foreman chases him down from behind and stops in there, but not before the big gain and first down for the Patriots at the Stingaree 20-yard line.
Durden drops back to pass again, sets up, tosses it out of bounds, nearly intercepted as he had pressure again that time for the Stings by, I believe that was Devontae Hinton.
Right, Hinton on the coverage, and then Dominique Allen. That ball was just thrown too high for him. If Allen could have gotten up and gotten that ball, basketball coach would have been after him before he got to the locker room, I can promise you. It was way up there, but he gave it his best shot.
Second down and 10.
That incomplete pass stopped the clock at 4:18 to play here in the fourth quarter.
Third with two receivers to the far side. He'll fake the handoff, keep it himself around the corner, and he tosses it, the late toss. Running back able to carry down, good for about 15 yards, 16 yards on the carry. And that'll be a first down as we have a sting down in the field.
Donald Lynch made the stop, and I believe that is Adrian West, but not positive just yet.
No, I think West is...
Yep, no, there's West, so...
Could be hitting.
We'll take a break with the injury timeout as well. 4 minutes, 11 seconds to play in the game. Sting's on top, 49-25. Injured Stingaree was Devontae Hinton, but he gets up, walks, trots over to the sideline on his own. Patriots looking at a second and goal from the four. Clock has started again. We're now under 4 minutes to play in the game.
Make it first and goal.
Oh, I'm sorry, yep.
Darden with the full house backfield. He's going to turn, give to the first man through, number 45. He's going to reach across for the touchdown. Don Rittenhouse, the 4 yard carry up the middle for the Patriot touchdown. That'll bring us to a score of 49-31, pending the PAT. As Godinez will line up for the extra point. Kick is up, and it is good. 3:40 left here in the ball game. Texas City 49, Goose Creek 32.
Patriots set to kick off after the touchdown and extra point. Texas City still leading 49-32. Jim wanted to just, I was looking back reading through the promo that they gave me about the throwback game. I like this, what it says is, dig into your closets. They want to see as many different shirts as they can find with those Stingaree shirts that are still wearable. I find it kind of interesting that they may have to put that in there, but I guess they do. You never know. Still wearable, folks. Make sure you can still wear it. And bring it out. Again, there'll be folks wandering around in the stands. They're going to try and find the oldest shirt that's being worn, and then that person will win a prize and have his or her name announced over the loudspeaker at the end of the game. So dig in your closet. There just might be a winner in there.
I wonder how many holes constitutes wear a hole.
Well, these days, I mean, you know, you can wear blue jeans, the Levi's that have lots of holes in them.
Sure.
And so I'm not sure. I'm not going to be the judge of that.
Patriots with a delay of game penalty on the kickoff here, so that'll back them up 5 yards. Would probably look for onside or pooch variety kick here. Stings has their hams team in there. And it's going to be kicked semi-deep.
Andrew Allen takes it at the 15-yard line, looking for some blockers. Doesn't see a whole lot of them, so he'll go down at the 25. So Texas City will start at their own 25 with 3:34 to play.
Yeah, looking for that. So that when you put that four-minute offense into play.
Exactly. That's
grind it out.
That's right.
Last couple plays, you can take the victory formation snaps. Coach Cervic and crew have to be pretty pleased with what they've seen from their team, especially offensively tonight.
Absolutely. Deontay Foreman and Donald Lynch in the backfield. Lynch gets the call, cuts it across. Now he's cutting across field. Wow, what a run. 50. 45 down to the 44-yard line for Donald Lynch. What a run. What's that, 31 yards? Somewhere around there.
31, you're right. And the clock will start as soon as they set the ball. It's in motion now.
Corey Johnson, junior wide receiver, brings the play in from the sideline. Stings will break the huddle with Johnson being wide to the near side here. Lynch gets the call again, cuts it up, and not a lot of room there. He might get a yard, yard and a half. They'll bring up second and 9.
Very impressive the way that the Stings took control late in that second quarter and haven't let off the gas yet. Shuffling players in left and right, and yeah, everybody wants that chance to showcase themselves.
Absolutely.
It doesn't matter if you're in the first quarter or the fourth quarter or up by 15, 17 points. It doesn't matter. You want to showcase.
That's right. Foreman gets the call. Stiff arms one. He'll go out of bounds after a gain of a couple. Hope to see a lot of Sting fans next Friday night at the Rig. Come on up I-35 to Pearland High School as the Stings take on one of the top-ranked teams in the state of Texas in Class 4A in the Pearland Dawson Eagles.
Yeah, it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't. Allen takes the snap. Going to keep it himself. Jukes and jives up very close to the first down, maybe just a half a yard shy as he gets inside the 35.
Close enough to go for it here, that's for sure, as you try to run out the clock.
That's right, a minute 45 and counting.
First down here effectively ends the ball game. They have a couple of timeouts left, but
17-point Stingaree lead, 49-32. Adrian West will go out wide to the far side, or Monty Foreman wide near. Allen takes a snap, and he'll just go forward, and he'll have the first down. He gets hit, falls back, but they're going to mark him with the progress up to the 33. And stop the clock.
Should be just enough to make the first down.
Looks like it might be close enough. Yep, they're going to bring the chains out.
I think he got it by the nose of the football.
Got it. Eagle Eye Tortorici saw that one. And that gives Texas City a new set of downs with a minute. The clock has already started with 1 minute. We're under a minute. Started the clock, and the chains weren't even back on the field yet. But that's okay. Allen under center, first and 10. Ball's on the ground. Still on the ground, and I believe the Patriots have recovered the loose ball. They're going to get it back with 36 and a half seconds left to play.
Yeah, just bad exchange there, center quarterback exchange. Turns the ball over to the Patriots. So they'll have last gasp effort to pad their stats if they want to.
That's right. Sting fans slowly starting to hit the exits and beat the rush on Palmer Highway. And Texas City calls a timeout. We're going to take the break as well. 36 seconds left to play. Stings on top, 49-32. After the timeout, the Patriots with a first and 10 from their own 30. With 36 seconds to play in the game.
Hand off up the middle. And he's going to break some tackles. Work his way down into Sting territory.
Zach Powell, number 9 for Texas City, junior defensive back on the stop.
That was Derek Barnum, the first man through the up back. And the clock will start running again, under 25 seconds now. They'll get maybe one more playoff, barring an incompletion. Pitch out, running rim to the right side, picking his way down inside the 20-yard line.
We're out of bounds by Dominique Allen.
And once again, as I mentioned, just a opportunity for them to gain some experience for some of their younger players on the early in the season here, the district season. These guys may get an opportunity to play later, so.
Sure, Coach Cervic and staff would like to keep them out of the end zone here with 8 seconds left.
Third, and they'll turn, hand it off to the up back, and that's time.
Nice read there.
Derek Bonner doesn't get a chance to go much of anywhere.
I believe that was Mike Petty, linebacker, senior linebacker for Texas City, making the stop.
And they're going to call a timeout, the Patriots do. Oh, wait, sorry, penalty.
Offsides against Texas City.
So they'll give them the 5-yard penalty.
2.4 seconds left to play. 2.4 excruciating seconds.
Well, it's not going to last long because they wind the clock.
And
that's going to be it.
That's it. That's the ball game. Final score here from Stingaree Stadium. The Texas City Stingarees win their first game of the 2012 district season 49-32 over the Baytown Goose Creek Memorial Patriots. We thank you for joining us. Jim Tortorici, thank you for filling in tonight for Dennis Disney Johns. I know he wishes he could be here, but it was a lot of fun, my friend. We had a good time.
Thank you. My pleasure. It's an exciting ball game, and nice to see a big Sting victory.
Absolutely. Folks, we appreciate you listening here with us as well, and we'll see you Friday night, 7 o'clock kickoff at the Rig in Pearland, Texas City, against the Pearland Dawson Eagles. Have a great week, everybody.